Hello lovely people, welcome to the Geek Cupboard, I'm Penge, and welcome back to Tavern Master, where we are very, very close to getting a third floor of the tavern, which of course means hotel rooms. At long, long last, we can get some hotel rooms here at the King and Kettle, which will be marvellous, because we have been waiting quite a long time. We unlocked the actual research thing down here for hotel rooms absolutely ages ago it seems now, but of course we've not really had anywhere to put them, so the new floor coming in means we can actually get some proper hotel stuff going on, which will be very good indeed. Now the eagle-eyed amongst you may have noticed that the research tree does look a little bit different. I think they've tweaked this recently in an update. So the new floor research that we're working on is now a kind of dead-end bit of research just here. Over here you can see that the extra chopping table has appeared. Now we noticed that this was missing last time, but now it's kind of appeared, which is wonderful. So maybe we shall work toward that to complete our upstairs kitchen, which will be very handy indeed. And then the final two bits of research, so an extra floor on top of the one that we're working on now, and unlimited kitchens, that's now hidden behind the plus 28 guests per day research. So yes, there must have been a recent update that's tweaked the research tree a little bit. But whatever the case, it doesn't really affect us too much. This is still fine. We can still work on our new floor, and we only need 54 more research points. So I think we'll get that tomorrow. I'm pretty sure we'll get that done tomorrow. Maybe sort of late in the day, possibly. I don't know, but there we go. That's all we need. That's going to be very exciting. And of course, when we get that in, we can actually complete some of these quests, because these two quests here, these two hotel quests, have been in place for quite some time. So it'll be quite nice to get those out of the way. Also, serve only soups. Did we do this last time? I cannot remember. Yes, we did. Yes, we did. Okay, so on the menu are only soups. Okay, right, that is wonderful. So let's go, hang on, did we do the bars? Yes, we did. Okay, good stuff. Right, let's go to the next day. Now, how quickly is this coming down? Come on, researchy people, bring this down. It's already on 50. So 8 a.m, it's on 50. I think that might be sort of, what, mid to late afternoon by the time that's done, but that's fine. That's fine. We can wait. This is very exciting. Okay, adventurers. Okay, what shall we do? Claim some coconuts. Very good. And claim some fish. How about, there's five of you back here, how about we send some of you out to defeat some bandits and get some sort of turkey leg things? So yeah, we'll have you and you and you. Okay, so you three go out and do that. And then we've got, what, 160 in total. How about you two go fishing? Yeah, you two spot, you know, go for a spot of fishing. It looks very nice. So there you go. Right, so all the adventurers are now out and about. This is all very good. Okay, right, hang on. Can we speed this on? Oh, it's tumbling. It is absolutely tumbling. This is very good. 10 down to 6. It's almost complete. Down to 2, and it's done. It is done. Okay. Now where do we go next? I mean, the chopping table is going to be really, really handy because the upstairs kitchen is not, you know, working properly because it's lacking an important sort of thing. So maybe we should start looking at getting the extra chopping table in, and then we just have to work on this, which is just research points. So do you know what? Yeah, let's start working on this and they can make a dent in the research points. Also, 200 rare guests. Now we have got a quest. Yes, organise any event once. Okay, right. So we want to bring in some red tier guests. Okay, so 240? Hang on. It wasn't that much before, was it? Have they tweaked the amount of guests that come in? Oh, I think they might have done. I am pretty sure that we've had, we definitely have had executioner meetups before, but I don't think we have 240 seats. Hang on. I'm pretty sure we've got nowhere near that. We've got 182 seats. Oh, so I wonder if these change with how, I don't know, how far you are along the research tree or something. I'm not entirely sure. We might have to do a work anniversary, which is not the best thing that we can do, because of course you don't get paid quite as much, but it's fine. It's absolutely fine. So there we go, a work anniversary. I don't know, that chappy there has been working at the same place for 50 years or whatever, so they're going to throw him a party over at the King and Kettle. Yeah, do you know what? That's 150 of those people. 150 red tier guests coming in, and that's fine. That's a good chunk toward that goal. Yeah, okay, right. Very happy with that. That is wonderful. Now, here we go. The big task of sorting out the hotel floor, because look, now we can go up to the extra floor. Now, immediately, I've just realised something. I've just had a bit of a thought there. Where are we going to put the stairs? Where are the stairs going to go? Okay, right. Possibly should have thought about this a little bit earlier. That's the stairs coming up just there. And they are the stairs coming up just there. I mean, ideally, you'd want the stairs going up in the same sort of area. So you don't go up one stairway and then have to walk all the way along to somewhere else to go up another set of stairs. So it'd be quite handy if, say, those stairs came up there and then the other stairs were here. Oh, but we have a lovely roaring fireplace here and a lovely suit of armour behind a little sort of behind a coat rack type thing. Could we move that? Seemingly not. No, hang on. Why can't we move you over? Hang on. You're a table. Move. Can we not move the tables anymore? Why can't we move this? Well, this is a bit of a problem if we can't move any furniture. Okay. Okay, hang on. Maybe do we need to click that type of thing? I'm not on the right floor. There we go. Right, yeah, we've done that before. Flashbacks to Crossroads Inn. Right, there we go. We're on the right floor. Hooray. Okay, if we move that over, that's all very good. That light's going to be a problem, isn't it? Okay, hang on. Where can we put that light for now? Pick that light up and just pop it over there for now. Because, I mean, really, the fireplace should cast some sort of light anyway. Move that out of the way and that out of the way. I don't think we can have the fireplace there anymore. Hang on a second. Right, so special, I think, stairs are special, are they? And I like the spiral stairs because they take up less space, I think, on the floor. They're quite easy to get in. So if we rotate them round. So hang on. No, that's not going to work. If we put them like that, and there's an R and an F. Nope, that's just moving between floors. Could we not, hang on, if they go in, could we not then twist them round a bit? Yeah, there we go. So you go up those stairs, and then you can then go up here, up to the next floor. That's fine. Of course, that now does leave us with a little bit of a random fireplace that's in the middle of nowhere. Hang on. I mean, that can go just there, and the coat rack thing can probably go just there. So I don't think that's going to get in the way. People come up here, so I don't think that's going to block anything. Right, we now have a random fireplace. Would anywhere like a fireplace? Where's going to befit a lovely, roaring, quite wide fireplace? I think, what if we... Nope, I don't think it's going to fit anywhere on this floor. Unless we just put it there. Do you know what? We'll just put it there for now. Is that going to block? Hang on. Is that going to block the route over there, though? Yeah, that's not good, is it? That's not going to work. Okay, do you know what? We might move it upstairs. For now, let's put it there. That makes utterly no sense at all, but we'll put it there for now. That's just so wrong. It's so wrong. We're going to move it up to the next floor. And then I think as well, they come up these stairs, they're going to need to go to another stairway over here. Although that means we're going to have to move our wonderful centerpiece painting there. That's fine. We can move that. We'll pop that on the wall just there. And then, yes, I want these sort of this table and chair arrangement to move somewhere. Again, I'm not entirely sure where. And when we could put it over here now, we could put it over there. Oh, that there's no light near that. There's a fireplace that gives off light. Okay, that's fine. Hang on. That's not a candlestick, is it? No, that's not a candlestick. Okay, just had to check. How about then? We pick that up. We put that just over here for now, just so it's out of the way again. This is all fine. It's all fine. It's all part of the grand plan, everybody. Right, we'll pop that chair there and then that chair there. Okay, right. So we've still got the same amount of seats. We do need to sort out a bit of lighting over here. So let's just pop some candles there. There we go. Nice and bright over there again. And then go back to special, grab the spirally stairs, and there we go. Perfect. So now people can actually get up to the next floor. And now we can go up to the next floor. So there we go. Right, so come out of this. So now we're going to need to sort out what we want to do with walls and such like. Okay. So floor textures first, I think. And let's have the nice floor. Let's have this floor here. I do like this floor. It seems wrong having kind of stone floors up the stairs a bit. So let's have the nice wooden floor. Now, the only thing is, I would like, because we're going to have to put a bar on this floor. As I understand it, we need to put a bar on this floor. And then we can assign waitresses to the bar on this floor, and the waitresses up here can be dedicated to room service. And then all the other waitressing staff, we can say, don't worry about room service. Because it's a bit annoying if a waitress on the ground floor has to go up two flights of stairs to go and, you know, change your bedsheet. So I think what we want is, we want a bar. We definitely want a bar on this floor. So I think what we'll do is, all of this stuff here can be as we expect. So there we go. So that can all be covered up, which is all very nice. But then maybe we have an outside bar. Now that's what I'm thinking we do. Just have an outside bar, kind of over here somewhere. Put it, maybe we'll have a sort of solid wall across here. And then just have a nice sort of outside bar area. That could be quite nice, couldn't it? And then we can have a little bit of outside sort of drinking. So an outside seating, but a bit like this. Keeping the theme of this side being kind of, you know, a little bit different to the rest of the sort of tavern. And then this can all be hotel rooms. I think that's going to be what we do. Now, how we can do that, I'm not entirely sure. Let's muck about and see, shall we? So there we go. All of that is now sort of covered up. Right, so then we go to here and we get some walls. I mean, let's go all the way down there with the walls because that makes sense. All the way along to there and do the same with that. And then wall texture. Come on, game. Come on, game. You know the deal by now. You know we have this wall texture. Stop it with this silliness. Right, there we go. Just throw that in. Is that all done? Definitely not on that side. Okay, right. So we've now got the general sort of layout. But then over here, yeah, we want another one of these. I think what we could do is, hang on. Let's have, if we have a door there and a door there, I imagine the bar can fit quite nicely between the two doors. Hang on. Is that me talking nonsense? Where's bar special? A bar. Right, I am talking a little bit nonsense, but not too much nonsense, which is rare. Yeah, let's put that just there. So the extra bar goes in. They're so cheap. The bars are so cheap. Okay, that's good. And then I think what we do is we fill that in and put the door. I mean, why don't you put the door at the other end? Just put the door at the other end and we'll move the bar so it's kind of more in the centre. There we go. That's okay. So they can serve a few tables out here and then they can run around and deal with all the rooms that are going to be in here. Okay, right. I think that's going to be the plan for now. This might be a terrible plan. I don't know. We'll work it out as we go along. And let's have this because I do quite like this. There we go. All the way across there. And to there. So again, a nice outside sort of drinking bit. It's all very lovely. And hang on a second. Give us the proper wall textures, please. There we go. The sort of, whatever they are, metal rivety things at the top. Right. There we go. Splendid. Right. So we have a bar, which means we can now get a new barman in. And we've, of course, got one sort of pending, which is very exciting. In fact, you know what? Let's do that now before I forget. So if we go down to this floor here. So, Chappy. So who are you again? Rob. Of course it is. Of course it is. Rob the barkeep. You can now go up to work on the third floor, which is very exciting. So I imagine, is he going to trundle off right now? He's going to deliver some drinks and then he's not going to go to the third floor. Good. The only thing is I want Hugo. We want Hugo because we unlocked him from our fancy quest shenanigans. But yeah, he is a level 10 bartender. But I want him to go on the ground floor because he's really, really good. And the ground floor is the busiest. You know, the first floor is very busy. So can we have you? Right, so hang on. So is he then going to walk in? I imagine he's going to come in the door at some point. Try and identify where he's going to go. Is he just going to teleport upstairs? Has he magically appeared? Yes, he has. Right, and he's serving water. Okay, maybe that's all we do. Oh, now they're all coming upstairs for water. This is terrible. Floor to serve only the second floor. You're only serving the second floor. I don't want you to be... Oh, this is very complicated. Okay, right. I'm sure this is all fine. You can just deal with water, but I want you to only deal with the third floor. But that means he only serves the third floor. So he's only going to serve drinks to people on the third floor. That's fine. That's fine. That's what we kind of want. But we want it... Hang on. We want that to be the other way round. How can we tell you to go to a different bar? I want you on the bottom floor bar. Yeah, I don't know how we do that. Maybe they'll sort that out tomorrow, possibly. Hang on. So if we say only the first floor, if we do that, we'll see what he does. And we won't put anything else behind the bar except water. But that means now we can have three waitresses on this floor. Okay, right. This is all getting a bit complicated. There's Hugo. Has somebody leveled up or something that I need to be aware of? There was a little notification thing. Maybe it's just because we got a new member of staff. Okay, that's fine. Hello, Rob the Guard. How are you? Right, okay. This is all not going entirely according to plan, but it's fine. We'll muddle through. So now we need to get this all set up with hotel room shenanigans. And what I think we're going to do is, on this floor here, it's going to be, I think we're just going to get sort of two big kind of bunk type rooms. So just two large, big bunkhouse hotel room type things. So we're going to have lots of beds in a couple of big rooms. And that's kind of it. And then on the top floor, when we unlock that finally, so on the fourth floor of the hotel, that's when we can have the fancy stuff going on. So the really elaborate, lavish, fancy rooms with all the fancy bits and bobs in them. That's what we do on the top floor. Because, you know, then they can have, you know, the penthouse suites and all that kind of stuff. Oh, hang on. From up here, we can see a little bit more of the castle. That's exciting. Look, there's kind of banner things. And there's a little kind of stable-y thing in there. And there's a kind of central keep type thing going on. Oh, that's quite exciting. Is there anything else around? No, just forests and then the big, bleak nothing of beyond. Okay, that's fine. Right, so let's get two rooms sorted out in here. So build and walls. Okay, so you're going to come up the stairs there. So I think if we put a wall going across like that. So if we have a room, I know, what about a big room like that? And then a big room like that. But then, of course, yeah, they're coming up these stairs and doing nothing at all. These stairs are unfortunately placed. Unless we have another big room across the middle, maybe. Well, how about that, actually? Hang on. Change this around. Right, abandon that plan. Away with you, wall. So you come up here, and that goes away as well. And then we just have ourselves... Hang on. How are we going to do this? That's quite big. That's 8 squares. But if we want two of these, I mean, what's... Nothing... This space isn't being used either. Nothing's going on in this space here. We don't really care about the quality of these rooms as such. So if we just put those there and went, okay, there's a bit of a space in there we could have a room. And then we could just have... I don't want the stairs going directly into the rooms because I think that's a bit rubbish. What if we did... This is awful. Right, what if we did... what if we did that? So three rooms like that. And then, yeah, we can have a little sort of corridor bit going out that way. So you can go up the stairs and over there, out to the drinking bit if you want to. And then we'll have to put a door into here. This is probably a really awful way around of doing things. Is there a better way to carve this up? I am not entirely convinced there is. Right, hang on. Let me just see if I can figure out a better way of sort of divvying this up here. Well, that sort of looks okay because it goes down the middle there. That's kind of nice and symmetrical. Down the bottom. It's just where those stairs come up. There's a little bit of a pain. Do you know what? That'll probably do, won't it? That'll do. If we just put a doorway just there. Put a doorway there. And you come up these stairs. You can have a doorway there and a doorway there. That's going to need a door to there. And then you're going to need a door going out that way. And then, yes, if you want to go through here, probably best to have a door there as well. Okay, right. So let's see now. So you can come up here. You can get to everywhere where you need to go. Come around here, come around there, go through here. Okay, right. Not brilliant, not perfect, but I think that will do the job. And then we can put some lovely decorative things in here. Oh, do you know what? We do need to do game. Come on. Come on, game. You know the defaults. Right, so paint that in. Very nice. There we go. Paint all those walls. Right, okay. So that's looking decent again. It's looking king and kettly. Right, and then I think, yeah, let's get this room sorted here. So the biggest one. So, okay, here we go. Now, is this going to work? I do not know. I mean, yeah, I kind of feel like, oh, look. Oh, this is very fancy. Strong beds. Are there more beds this time around? I think there might be more beds. How about then, if we're going to try and get something fairly good. I don't want it to be like a dive. I want it to be quite a nice, although it's going to be like a bunk room. I want it to be a nice bunk room. So how about just some silk beds? That seems like a nice thing. So if we go, okay, silk bed, silk bed, silk bed, silk bed. Okay, oh, however, is that going to work? Because, yeah, people are going to come in and pay that much. I don't know. Do you know what? Let's try it, shall we? Let's see if it works. So I'll put a silk bed and another silk bed and opposite that one. Another silk bed and opposite that one. Another silk bed. Right, okay. And then we need wardrobes. Okay, so how about we put a lovely cabinet down this end, kind of in the middle. So, yeah, okay, pop a cabinet in. Right, and what else do we need? We need some decor, don't we? I think we need some items of decor, do we? Or do we need a miscellaneous kind of thing somewhere? I don't know. How big are the bedside tables? Oh, they're a little bit too... They're a little bit too big. Okay, how about a writing table? Let's put a writing table at that end. Okay, what's the problem here, game? What's the issue? This room has more than 5 beds, which is over the maximum amount of allowed beds inside a room. Okay. Right. Okay, everybody, you can only have 5 beds in a room. Right, okay, let's start reshuffling this entire plan then, because that is not going to work with all that space we've got up there. Okay, right, let's just move the beds out for now. Just park them out on the on the drinking balcony. This is all fine. It's all part of the plan. We knew this was going to happen. Right, okay, so try and line these up as best we can. So put one just there and one over there, and then drag that thing out there. And go and pick up the writing table and put it back there. Okay, right, so now the outside bit's not happy, but that's understandable. Okay, right, let's go back to here and let's see if we can divvy this up into slightly smaller rooms then. Let's see if we can break this up into a slightly smaller sort of room arrangement, which means we can have 5 beds in each room. So I think, yeah, if we just have them along, if we have it sort of, what, 8 by 2? That might make sense. We have 8 by 2 and have 4 beds in each, and then they can each have a little bedside table. Maybe that's what we do. Okay, right. Let's see what we can do. Let's see if we can just take all these walls apart again and then just, I don't know, hit things with hammers and see if we can make things look good. Okay, so if we then say, okay, so that's one room. That's fine. That can be another room. That's good. And yeah, this bit here does trouble me because you have to come up the stairs and go through one room to go into another, which I find a bit weird. you could have a door there going straight into there. So there we go. So they've got 2 rooms there. So that will accommodate 4 beds. We'll have 4 beds in each. So that's fine. So 4 and 4. And then we could have, what's that? 1, 2, 3. We could have a room like that. So a slightly smaller room. And then we could divvy that up as well. So we could have that like that, and then, oh, do you know what we could use this for? We could use, hang on, are we allowed to even put the stairs in? Because of course we need to get up to the next floor, so we could put the stairs in to the next floor right now. Now we haven't of course unlocked the next floor, but we can at least put the stairs in position. Oh, and those stairs they're facing sort of the wrong way. Yeah, that's... Hang on. It's impossible to rotate this. I know, because I put it in the wrong way. Silly. Right, there we go. Splendid. That's a bit better. Do you want to put that like that? Yes, I think we do. And that one is okay, but let's put that like that. Okay, right. So now they're in. So those two little sort of corridor bits do actually make sense now, these two bits. That's fine. But is that okay in terms of rooms? I think that should be okay now. Right, hang on, go back to here, grab us some doors. We are lacking windows around the place, aren't we? Definite lack of windows going on. Okay, we'll have a window there. We'll have a window just there. We'll have another window on this side. Window there, and hang on, a window just there, so it's not kind of in the way of the stairs. Window there, and one there. Okay, and now we need some doors, because no one's going to do anything at all. So there we go, so we'll have a little tiny sort of room here. Yeah, the only thing that annoys me is that you're going to have to walk through, which I don't like. You're going to have to walk through somebody else's room to get to your room, which I don't really like the idea of. Okay, we'll put a thing there. So come up here and go into that room, or come up here and go into these rooms. And yeah, I don't really like that idea, but that might be the way that we have to do things. Okay, pop a door just there as well. Okay, so we can get access to this room anyway. And this one. Perhaps we rework this. But right now, let's just get some basic hotel stuff going on. Right, here we go. Nope, that's the wrong button. Back we go. Okay, so hotel bed goes in. And it's one of the vaguely nice ones. And again, let's push it so it's as close as it can be. No, not there. Onto gap of two, please. There we go. And that one there. Rotate that round. And then this one here. Okay, so put them in like that. Then we can get bedside tables. And I like the idea of that. So bedside table, bedside table, bedside table, bedside table. That fits wonderfully. Okay, happy with that. Now, what is it saying? Doesn't have a wardrobe. Okay, well, hang on a second. Oh, hang on. No, we've already got a cabinet. Let's grab us a cabinet and tuck it onto that wall there. Right, that room is now a valid hotel room. We can charge 300 monies for this, which is quite nice. Okay, so requirements for 2-star, a light. Yes, lights would help, wouldn't they? Sort of forgot about the lights going on. Okay, so now that room is lovely and well lit, which is very handy. So yeah, we've got lights, and now it's so it's definitely a 1-star. It's a 2-star. It's a 3-star room. We could make it a 4-star bunk room. All beds in room are 4 stars or more. All wardrobes. Do you know what? I'm quite happy with that being a 3-star room right now. But then what if we put more things in? What if we put more lovely things in? So yes, we'll grab the writing table and put that in. Now, does that mean that we can charge a little bit more money for this? So let's have a look. Yeah, there we go. So we can charge, 80% chance the bed is going to be rented. Then if we put more fancy things in, we can actually charge a bit more money, which is very nice. So let's have a little sort of dressing area over here. So pop a mirror in, and then we've got a room divider. Oh, this is good. Yeah, so you can get changed over there. A little bit of a gap near the end of that bed, but that's okay. And then a bathtub. Possibly, the bathtub needs to go behind the divider, I would have thought. A clock. That's no bad thing. Pop a clock into there. Okay, very nice. And just random sort of decor. What can we put in here? I mean, how about next to, in between there, a lovely bookshelf. That's very nice. And, yes, hang on a second. Hang on. Where's the the stupidly positioned fireplace? Right, go up a floor. Now let's put a fireplace. Right. Possibly just there. Although, hang on. Move that out of the way. Put that in the corner. Nice. No, not there. Not there. Move out of the way, fireplace. Put that in the corner. There we go. Writing desk in the corner. That just there. And can that go there? Or is the light going to interfere? No. There we go. Perfect. Okay, so now, 80% chance. Okay, that's fine. That's fine. So we can make 75 money. Do you know what? What if we drop it? 82%. 83%. Do you know what? We don't really need the money. So there we go. So that will do. I quite like that. Do you know what? No, I don't like that. I don't like this room at all right now because it's not got the right walls. Away with you terrible walls. Stop this. Stop sullying the tavern. Okay, there we go. Splendid. Nice walls going in. Paint them on. Okay, right. Good. So one hotel room is now sorted. Took a while, but it does look very nice. It looks like a nice hotel room. So you come up and there you go. 4 beds in there. Now that means we can complete these. So have a 1-star hotel room. Thank you very much. Build 1 hotel room. Thank you very much. Give us some free money. Very welcome indeed. Okay. Do you know what? That will do for now. That will do. There's some beds out here. Stupid way. However, what I think we should do is, I think we should get quite a lot of staff and assign them to this bar, and then tell them to only deal with this floor, if that's how it works. I do find this a bit befuddling. Okay, so here we go. Now, is anybody good at, like, tidying or anything like that? Can carry 8 drinks at the same time. There's so many good people. We don't really want you carrying drinks so much. We want you to be doing the whole room cleaning stuff. Okay, how about our mood is not affected by cleaning? Okay, does that mean cleaning hotel rooms? Helga, you're hired. Now, does that mean Helga is immediately going to come over to... Didn't mean to press that. Come over to here. Is Helga going to run up to this floor? And are you Helga? I suspect you might be. Yes, hello Helga. Right, so our cleaning is different to room service. Botherations. Okay, only serve the third floor, please. And you can low prioritise food, because there's no sort of way to get any food at the moment, because there's no tables. But yeah, you can just do room service. And is that how this is going to work right now? I don't know. Let's see how this works. Like, is he going to do... He's bought some drinks. Hang on a minute. Hang on. We're lacking ingredients. Oh, crikey. Okay, hang on a second. Restock. Restock the food. Yeah, that was very low on everything. And over here, restock that. That was also quite low. And that one not quite so bad. Okay, right. Yeah, move time on. Nice and quick. I want to see if people actually move in here. I want to see if people actually, you know, go and stay the night. Hang on a second. You know what is going to be helpful? Lights. Okay, let's pop a light just there. Which I realise isn't the best type of light right there, because you're going to keep banging your head on it, but it's okay. And then we'll pop a light just there, so those little bits are lit at least. Okay, right, wonderful. There we go. Oh, we need some lights out here as well. Hang on, lights behind the bar would probably be helpful. And by the door, and by the door. And then we'll put some across this side, so one on the end, one on that end, and one in the middle. Okay, lovely. That's nice and well lit. I like that. Looks also lovely and glowing. Very nice. In the early evening. Very good. Okay, right. So now this is here. It looks like a nice room. I wouldn't mind staying there. But there we go. Right, let's see if anybody actually comes and stays over the night. That'll be really good. Get our first guest in. Oh, and something's leveled up. The leek soup has leveled up. 4-star leek soup. That is very good. That's very good. Right. Is anybody going to stay the night? Please, somebody stay the night. It's taken us an awfully long time to sort this out. It'd be really good if somebody could stay. But no, it looks like, yeah, it looks like Helga is waiting on this floor, which is very good. That's very handy. The other ones are still coming up to this floor, which is a little bit befuddling, but okay. But no guests. No guests. Oh, this is a bit sad. Maybe it needs a day for the word to go around that we actually have a hotel service now. Maybe it's going to take a day for that to kick in. Okay, never mind. Well, there we go. We can claim that. So that's another 4 quest target thingamajigs. We are getting very close to being able to ask Vikings round, which will be very exciting. However, we lost quite a lot of money there because we spent a massive load of it on stuff and building walls and knocking them down again. We've got 182 seats. Hang on a minute. Where are they? Vikings. 240. So we can't actually seat all the Vikings quite yet. Okay, never mind. Never mind. Right, so come down here. Let us restock behind that bar. And we'll refill behind the other bar as well. And there we go. Okay, only 62 behind that bar. What? Why was there only 62 behind that bar? What's going on there? That seems a little bit low. Okay. right, that's very odd. That's completely unexpected. That's thrown me a bit. I thought it'd be a lot more than that. Okay, fine. Do you know what? Hang on. Do we have anything else to do here? Organise any event once. I mean, yeah, tomorrow is an event. So start the next day. Rob the guard? No, not rob the guard. Okay, organise any event once. Sorted. Okay, so have a 4-star hotel room. Okay. Okay, we could do that, I suppose. Finish any research. Okay, we're heading towards some. Prepare cheese. Oh, no. It's one of these. Prepare cheese 36 times for 2 quest arrow target things. That hardly seems worth it. That hardly seems worth a reward. Okay, well, here we go. Here's the work anniversary. So everyone's coming in to celebrate, I don't know, some sort of person being at work for a long time. Well done, that person. Okay, let's go over to here. Hooray, we got some ham stuff. Hooray. Ah, hang on. We can only take 12 of those. Okay, yeah, that's fine. And 7 lots of peas. Okay, so don't go and pick up any more walnuts. We'll have some strawberries because we're going to be out of those by the end of the day. So you, bold, noble hero, you go strawberry picking. I assume they go strawberry picking in, you know, the Forest of Doom, or, you know, they go, whatever, mushroom picking in the Misty Forest of Inevitable Getting Your Legs Cut Off or whatever. But yeah, okay, so you can go out and grab us some mushrooms. Thank you very much. You can go out and grab us some peas. 2 of you can go out and... Oh, hang on a minute. Hang on. We've got 1 slot left. Do you know what? Let's ascend all of you, because why not? There we go. That keeps everybody busy. We've seated all the people, which is very good indeed. Hang on a second, something has leveled up. Strawberry cake has leveled up. Wonderful, very nice. Oh, do you know what? Let's put all the menu stuff back on. Everything, all the stuff back on the menu. And something has happened in here. Judy the waitress has leveled up. She's going to go to level 10, which is very good, because that means she gets an extra trait. So what's she going to get? She can carry 8 drinks. Okay, right, hang on. Let's rejig your skills. There you go. You can now carry 8 drinks, which is wonderful. And we'll give you 2 in that and 2 in that. Possibly a point in climbing stairs. Another 2 on that. We'll give you 1 for tips, because yeah, you can get a little bit of extra money. That's okay. And then we'll put 1 in each of those. There you go. So you're quite balanced. You're quite a balanced sort of, got a balanced set of skills there, which is okay. So you're very good at drinks. Cleaning, yeah. Food, not so bothered. Room service, don't care. Okay, right, this is all fine. Oh, and hang on, they've leveled up. Okay, well done. I mean, we'll give you a point in that, and Nancy's leveled up as well. Have a point in that. Has anybody else leveled up? I've just not noticed. No. Okay, right, this is all good. Now, what's going to go on upstairs now? Have we got people coming into the hotel room? No, we have not. Oh, come on, somebody. Somebody going, poor Helga. Poor Helga is just sort of standing here, not doing anything. Right, you. See, this confuses me. Only serve the first floor. And then you should be only... Oh, you're only serving the... Oh, hang on a minute. Hugo's still up here. Hang on. Only serve the third floor. I don't know how we move the people between floors. I'm not entirely sure. Only serve the first floor. Right. That's why we weren't serving many drinks. That's why we didn't restock the bar very much, because the barkeep down here was only serving the third floor. So nobody was ordering any drinks from Rob down the first floor, because there's nobody up on the third floor. And then up on the third floor, we only had water. Oh dear. Right, okay, hopefully that's sorted. I wonder how many people noticed that and went, oh my goodness, Pedge, what are you doing? But there we go. All sorted. It's all fine. It's all fine. Okay. There we go. I want to get through and just make sure that people actually stay here. Because it would be nice if we could at least get somebody. It'd be lovely if we get at least somebody staying over the night. I mean, time is ticking by. Somebody else has done something over here. Have they? Yeah, Nancy's leveled up. Well done, Nancy. Okay, so level you up. You can already carry 8 drinks. Let's get speed not carrying up like that. There we go. That's very good. Do we need to go and look at who's doing what on what floor? We might do that at the end of the day. Okay, let's get through to the end of the day. Get through to the end of the party. We'll see how that's going with our research. In fact, it's going to complete the research. It's absolutely going to complete that research. We can get a chopping table in. Oh, this is very good. Okay, do you know what? Yeah, by the end of this party, by the end of the do, it will be sorted. Our research is going to be done. Only a couple of hours. And here we go. People are leaving. Party's coming to a close. The big work celebration's finished. Some people very sensibly going home early because they've got to go back into work tomorrow. Some people are not bothered and they're staying here late. But yeah, that's going to be done as soon as they all get booted out. And here we go. Down it tumbles. I was expecting that to be kind of complete. Oh, okay. I thought that was going to go down to zero, but no, not quite down to zero yet. So yeah, we didn't make much in the way of money. Because, yeah, we messed the whole thing up there. But, okay, no, that's fine. That's fine. It was a party. We don't get much money from them drinking their things. Okay. Refill everything. Go. We can't go up a floor whilst we're in this menu. Okay, so then refill this. 114. And then, of course, we have the bar up here. Refill the water for nothing. So the water we get for free and we charge 8. I sort of feel a bit bad. Still nobody in the hotel. Unless that's because... It's rob the guard, scare them away, rob the guard. Well done, rob the guard. Good job. Yep, defended against thieves. What have we got? Serve any main courses for the whole day. Ah, botherations. Okay. We can't do that today. So yeah, maybe nobody stayed in the hotel room yesterday because it was an event day. So the kind of the tavern is shut down in its entirety for events only. So maybe today we should see some people coming in. I really hope we do. I really hope we do, because that would be rubbish if not. Do you know what we are going to do? Just to make that room look a little bit more even. Put another window in just there. A couple of windows on that side. I quite like that. Yeah. Okay. Right. Let's see how we get on. Now, this should be done. This should be done by the end of the day. It should be done fairly quickly. Oh, crikey, somebody else. Johnny, the original chef. Okay, let's level you up. And you can have a point of speed, my good sir. You can zip about the kitchen ever so slightly faster. Oh, the smoked ham has leveled up. Okay, right, so smoked ham has leveled up. Ah, yes, of course. I put everything onto all of the menus. So smoked ham is now not just for pirates. It's for everybody, so everybody can enjoy the pirate platter. They can pretend they're a pirate if they want to. Okay, there we go. Look at that. Average of 2.86 for our food now. It's looking very good. The apple pie is looking pretty close to leveling up. The bread isn't looking too bad. The bowl of chicken, that's almost there. Chicken in a basket has almost gone up. And mushroom soup and the green pea stew are not looking too bad either. Okay, that is very good. How much fish do we have? Is it worth putting fish stew onto the menu? Because I think we have got quite a lot of fish. I've just realised that we have a load of adventurers just sort of sitting about waiting for us to, tell them to go somewhere. Right. So don't go and get any more turkey things. Fish, however, yes. Let's go and get some more. We can't get any more fish. Okay, cheese. We've got to serve a load of cheese. You go and protect a wagon and get some cheese. And you get some coconuts. Three of you can go and do that. There we go. Go and get some coconuts, please. Splendid. The bowl of chicken's leveled up. Average of 2.9 now. Wonderful stuff. Okay, anybody in the hotel room, please tell me someone's going to come up here. It took us so long to get this sorted and nobody cares. It's lovely. Look at it. Very spacious. Oh, hang on. And we've completed the research. There we go. We've unlocked the... What was it? Walnut cake, was it? We've unlocked the walnut cake for the Vikings. Not that we can seat all the Vikings. And that research is done. Okay, so we're going to put one of those in at the end of the day. And now we've just got to go toward the plus 28 guests per day research. Because now that's key to get these last two bits in the new sort of rejig tree. So, okay, we'll start work on that. 233 research points. Might take a little while. Might take a little while. Not quite sure why this room isn't going. A little bit confused. 83% chance the bed will be rented. And no, nothing. Nobody's renting the room at all. Which is a shame. I thought it looked quite nice. I don't quite know what's going on there. And I mean, we've employed Helga. We've employed lovely Helga here to go and do room service on this floor. Oh no, hang on. Here we go. There are people. There's three people in here. Hello, hello, welcome, welcome. Oh, this is very good. This is very good. I mean, we could. Four people. Welcome aboard. This is very exciting. I like the way you went down the tiniest gap of the bed on that side, rather than the huge gap on the other side. But there we go. Okay, right. I'm happy with this. This is good. We've actually got people staying in the hotel at long, long last. I was thinking we could just get this up to a five-star room. All the beds in the room are five stars. We can afford that. All the wardrobes are five. We can put a bathtub in. And then we can sort... I mean, yeah, we could just get a nice five-star bunk sort of room. A five-star dormitory going on. Because we've almost got all the bits and bobs we need anyway. It's not too much of a bother to actually get the other ones in. So I think maybe we should look at that. Is that worth doing? I think maybe. Let's not do that now. Because, of course, we have people in the room. And that's going to disrupt their sleep and everything. That's going to be very disruptive. So let's just do what we need to do. Let's go down. Let's come out of that menu. Let's go to here. Okay, so refill that. Very nice. And go down to here. And refill this. Okay, that looks a little bit better. Those numbers look like they should. So, yeah, people have been taking a lot of drinks away from this bar here. Which is what we'd expect. Okay, did we have any angry people? No. No angry people. Lots of people on the 11th, but that was a bit of a terrible day. That was when we had the slight organisational mishap. Okay, I think everything is back working as it should be. Okay, so now serve only main courses. So no desserts, no soups, no desserts, no soups. Sorry, fish stew. Onto the menu and then away with you. Okay, so begin the next day. Let's see how we get on. No rob the guard required. Okay, so that's going to be done. Organise any event once. Okay, that's fine. And now I think we pop up here. Let's have a little look as Helga Is Helga running around sorting the rooms out? Is she doing a spot of room service? I mean, she might have possibly finished by that point. The beds look all sort of made. Okay, right, let's upgrade this room then. Let's make this a nice fancy room. So sell that bed, sell that bed, sell that bed, sell that bed. That's going to go red because it's going to go, whoa, what are you doing? Okay, it's all got to be 5-star good stuff. Okay, so fancy luxe bed number 1 going in, and 2, and 3, and 4. Okay, fancy beds have gone in. So now what else do we need? Wardrobes and a bathtub. Okay, so we need a fancy, we need a huge wardrobe. So away with you, rubbish wardrobe. Let's put in a huge wardrobe, which just about can just get away with. The light is a little bit in the way of the door, but that's fine. It doesn't matter. And then if we can somehow fit a bathtub in here, you can't buy a new prop. Okay, hang on. Pop that there for now. Right. So let's see if we can rejig this ever so slightly. So can we move that to over there for now? And then put that, say, there. That, I think, should go in the corner. That, I think, should go in the corner. Thank you very much. Yeah. That's a bit of a blocker right there, isn't it? People are going to have to jump over the bed. That's not great, is it? How about... Hang on. How about we rejig the entire room to fit this thing in? Right, throw that into there for now. Okay, writing desk in the corner. Big wardrobe-y thing just there. Then we move the mirror. Hang on. Then we move the mirror over to there. Pop that into that corner because then it doesn't really matter about over here so much. That's fine. They can squeeze around there. They can hop in on this side of the bed. And then the mirror can go not there. Okay, hang on. This is fun. We can move things over a bit. Put that... Oh, hang on. Bring that over like that. Put that there. Put the fireplace there. Nope, that's overlapping. Hang on. Go there. And then the mirror can go just there. Okay. Is that allowed? It's a 5-star room. We can charge an awful lot of money. Hang on. Bring it down to 220. 96% chance the room is going to be rented. Hang on. What's 100? 98. What if we bring it down to 200? Yeah, there you go. 100% chance. So if we just say, yeah, okay, that's fine. I'm okay with it being rented. So bring that down. There we go. And that's, oh, hang on, no, that's still too high. Hang on, 200, wasn't it? There we go. So we can make 800 money every night. We will, because it's guaranteed. There's a 100% chance that bed is going to be rented. So we're going to make 800 money every single day from this hotel room. No questions asked. It's just going to happen because it is. Okay, that is very good. That is very good. I mean, the other rooms aren't set up quite well yet, but we shall get there. And we've had a 4-star hotel room. Thank you very much. I mean, look, we're getting toward the end of things here. What's the maximum thing? 420 quest arrow things. We've got 345. We are working toward that. That is very good. That is very good indeed. Okay, and the research is ticking down. I mean, do we plan in... I mean, what's this? 500. 500 gold tier people and 6 royal tier people for the new floor. I think it might be worth getting that in. Is it worth getting that in? It possibly is. Do you know what? Let's get that in. And we'll have pirates, because I think we can have pirates. That's 180 of those people. We can't seat the Vikings. I'm going to have chairs. So, do you know what? Yeah, pirates. And I think this is going to be done by the end of the day. I think that is going to be finished because it's 6 p.m, 7 p.m. right now. So they've got the entire evening to work through this final handful of research points. And then we immediately move it onto this and they can make a tiny, tiny dent into the 2,500 they need to get the extra floor on. Oh my goodness me. Okay, there we go. Right, start research on that. An extra 28 guests per day. I mean, I suppose that's quite handy. How about the prices? 513 increase. 296. Do you know what? I think that's okay. I think we can deal with that. That's fine. And I was thinking, while I was sort of waiting and time was passing by, do we need this up here? Thinking about it now, we need the bar. I think we need the bar up here because the bar allows us to have a waitress that is dedicated to this floor. And if this is going to be just a pure hotel floor, we can have this one waitress who can go around the place and just do all the room service stuff. And that's fine. And I think all the other floors are now managing. All the other floors are coping very nicely indeed. Everything looks very busy and bustling. Lots of people in. It looks marvellous. It looks wonderful. Look at it. Romance corner. A little bit empty in the actual corner of Romance Corner, but that's fine. It's looking very, very good. But yeah, do we need this big outside bit here if we just, yeah, there's nobody drinking here? This is just kind of dead space. We could turn this into some sort of, you know, fancy hotel room. I mean, do we turn it into a room, like an outside room? Do we just tuck the bar away somewhere in the middle over here? Just say, yep, there you go. The bar's in the middle. It's fine. Just, you know, lock the bar away in there, hide it away, and then have this as kind of like, I don't know, a couple of lovely outside sleeping areas for a sort of alfresco night sleep at the King and Kettle. Maybe that's what we do. That might be worth doing. Yeah, I think that's probably a good idea. So put the bar into here, so it's in the middle. Just sort of lock that away, hide it away. That can be a fancy room. That could be a fancy room. And then that could also be a fancy room. And then this could be two rooms. I like that. That idea seems to make sense. Okay, there we go. That's sort of a plan. But we'll do all this stuff, not right now, because of course stuff is happening. How are we looking over here? We have two people in these beds. And that's good, because somebody is in that bed. So they got past this sort of screen thing. These two beds here, however, game, I can't help but notice that nobody's in those beds. I feel slightly aggrieved. I feel slightly aggrieved by the 100% chance that this bed is going to be a hired out number you gave us, game. Because that's clearly a fib. You've lied to us, Tavern Master. Okay, we've completed that. Okay, thank you very much. 349. How much cheese have we prepared? 7 out of 36. Oh my goodness me. Okay, right. Let's go and do the necessary bits and bobs. So let's get this. Refill that. 452 to refill that. Good grief. That's 276. Wow. Okay, right. That's all good. This one up here, I imagine, is nothing. It cost nothing anyway, but it was all full. Okay. So now I think what we do is we move that bar to in there. And then, hang on. That's a bit of a silly way around, isn't it? Put it there so it can sit there in that room and just not do anything. I do feel a little bit annoyed that this guy isn't going down to the ground floor. He's a really good barkeep. He's like our finest barkeep. He's brilliant. He's on a floor where nothing is happening. And I don't think we can specify what floor he works on. He just went to the available bar, which is a bit of a shame. Okay, if anybody knows how to make him go down to the ground floor, that'll be wonderful, but I'm not entirely sure that's going to happen. Okay, so now that can go in there. And then, yeah, if we just sort of put a little sort of dividing wall down there, we can have a nice outside room here and an outside room here. And then, yeah, do we keep this the same? Maybe. I don't like the fact that we have to... I don't like the fact that you have to walk through a room and then through another room to get to this room here. I don't like that at all. That's not really good enough. This is fine. Up the stairs into there, that's okay. And up the stairs and into this one, that's fine. So I think, yeah, we need to do something with this over here. Not overly happy with that. But you know what? I think what we'll do is we will do all that kind of stuff next time out. Today, I just wanted to get the hotel stuff unlocked and in, and we've done that and more. In fact, hang on. I was going to finish up. We're not going to finish up quite yet because, of course, we can put in the final... Where is it? Chopping board thing. There we go. Chopping board goes into here, and that does make that room look a little bit busier now, doesn't it? But there we go. So a chopping board is now in our second floor kitchen, which will hopefully make their lives ever so slightly easier. There we go. Wonderful. And now I think we shall finish things up because, yeah, we've got the hotel stuff in. I mean, you know, there should be two people there. There are not. The game has tricked us. It's hoodwinked us. But there we go. Never mind. So that's sorted. I'm happy with the way that's going to set up. I think the bar being here is pretty good. I think that little space there does need to be set aside for the bar so we can have dedicated staff for this floor, because we want this this floor to be cleaned and, you know, somebody to go around and make all the beds and what have you. So I think that's okay. That's fine. But then, yeah, what do we do with this space over here and this space over here? Can we make this slightly less rubbish in terms of how you get to these rooms? I do not know, but yes, we shall have a look at that next time, I think. That can be our plan for the next part here in Tavern Master, because yes, we'll finish things up for now. Hopefully you are still enjoying this. If you are, please do leave a like. That would be most marvellous indeed. And also, if you're not already, then please do subscribe to keep up to date with how we get on here next time out in Tavern Master. But for now, thank you very much for joining me in the Geek Cupboard, and I will see you next time. He's gone down the lift, even though they're not built. The lifts aren't finished. People, this is very dangerous. Martin said it's fine and gave me a negative review. You silly man, Martin. You've clicked the wrong button. Looked like he had no trousers on, which was a little bit strange. Oh, Linda, with your gleaming golden words of appreciation. Linda says, an okay hotel.